Welcome to the Sidekick Character Creator walkthrough. In this quick tour, we'll dive into the key features of the tool, give you a clear look at what you can create, customize, and control. Let's jump in and start building some characters. Let's start with the Presets tab. Here we have broad control over making characters. We can generate characters from the packs in your scene to customize your character based on the presets made for those parts. The Randomize Character button shuffles the character parts to instantly generate a unique character, making it easy and fast to create new variations each time. To further refine the parts you're working with, use the Part Filter tab located just above this button. It lets you control which parts are included in the mix, allowing you to narrow down or expand your creative options as you build your character. If you need more control over which part of the character you want to adjust, it's broken down into sections: the head, upper body, and lower body. There's also body type, which adjusts the shape of the character. Below that, there's colors, which is broken into species, outfit, attachments, and materials. You can also switch between species at the top of the interface. Species define the type of character you're creating. For example, human, goblin, zombies, and more. This lets you easily build combinations like a zombie pirate or goblin knight, mixing and matching styles and themes with creative freedom. Now let's take a look at the Parts tab. This section allows you to fine-tune every aspect of your character, divided into three main areas: the head, upper body, and lower body. Before you dive in, remember to check which species you're working with. You can change it at the very top of the tool. You can quickly explore new combinations by randomizing an entire section or just individual parts. Above the parts list, preset filters let you narrow down or broaden the selection, giving you more creative control and flexibility. If you want to remove a part, simply click the X icon on the left side of the part listing, and this will be removed. You can simply add it back by going to the drop-down menu and selecting the part again. Let's take a look at the Blends tab. This section gives you precise control over your character's body type, proportions, and musculature. Just adjust the sliders to quickly shape and refine the overall form to suit your design. The Colors tab gives you full control over your character's color palette. At the top, you can choose to filter by specific sections, like a head, outfit, or attachments, or leave it set to all to make broad changes across the entire character. Whether you're fine-tuning details or overhauling the whole look, this is where your style can really come to life. Once you're happy with your character, you can save out an SK file and load that SK file back in. You can continue making changes, and once you're happy, you can export this as a prefab. This allows you to bring in the combined character into your project. Thanks for watching. Hope you found this walkthrough useful. Looking forward to seeing what you create.